Cheers erupted at the port in Mobile, Alabama, as the Carnival Triumph came into view.
It's been a true nightmare for me. This is my first cruise, and I probably will not do another one.
But some passengers are crediting a heroic crew.
They're still folding the toilet paper to make it look nice. They're taking care of the elderly. If there's anybody that needs to get extra money out of this, without a doubt, it is that amazing, incredible, excellent cruise.
Passengers have detailed wretched conditions on board after a fire Sunday cut off the electrical system and left the Triumph adrift.
Every line for every meal is at least an hour, hour and a half. Boat has listed at least 6 to 18% for days. The smell has accumulated. It's making us sick. I mean, it's horrid.
On shore, Carnival has a small army of workers ready to make their arrival as smooth as possible.
Inside the terminal, there's also warm food available. There are blankets, there are cell phones, and refreshments available for the guests that need that or want that assistance.
To Triumph's tired and frazzled passengers, dry land has never looked so good.
Now, the process of getting all these people off this boat is not fast. It's pretty slow. There are 4,000 people on board, 3,100 passengers, plus another 1,000 crew. They all have to come out through one door up one elevator. The passengers have two options. They can get on a bus for Galveston, Texas, or they can go to New Orleans, where they'll get a hotel and a chartered flight in the morning to go to Houston, and from there go home. So hopefully within the next day or so, all of these people will finally get to go home. Reporting in Mobile, Alabama, I'm Sara Ganim.